You are welcome to today's class. The subject is economics. The subject is economics. The topic we'll be looking into in today's class is concept of demand. We're looking into concept of demand. By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to divine what you mean by demand. You'll be able to divine demand, what demand is. And again, secondly, you'll be able to state the laws of demand. And thirdly, you'll be able to mention some factors that affect demand. Now, we come to demand. We say that what is demand? We say demand can be defined as the amount of goods and services in which a consumer is willing to buy at a particular period of time within a given price. What we say is that if demand can be defined as the amount of goods and services in which a consumer is willing to buy at a particular period of time within a given price. As you can see it on the board, we say demand can be divided as the amount of goods and services in which a consumer is willing to buy at a particular period of time within a given price. What is demand? When we talk about demand, we're talking about the amount of goods and services in which a consumer is willing to buy. For instance, this is clean detergent soap. I'm willing to buy this clean detergent soap. I may have the money to buy it, I might not have money to buy it. For instance, this is 100 naira. I'm on this 100 naira with me. I'm willing to buy this thing that I get soap. We will call this demand. Am I to demand for this soap or not? When we talk about demand, we say it's the amount of goods and services in which a consumer is willing to buy. I'm willing to buy this thing. I want to do what? Demand for clean. You know, I said I want to do what? Demand for clean. Did I have money to buy it or not? If I'm having money to buy the plane, there's something we call it. If I don't have money to buy it, but I wish to demand for it, there's also what we call it. But what you actually mean by demand is when you are willing to buy a particular goods and services at a particular price, then we say that you are demanding for such goods. So that your demand, it can be effective demand and it can be what? Ineffective demand. It can be effective demand and it can be what? Ineffective demand. When it is effective demand, what does it mean? It shows that you have the purchasing power to pay for the goods and services you are demanding for. For instance, I want to buy this plane. I'm having 100 naira with me to pay for the plane. Then if I'm paying this 100 naira to get this plane, then we look if I do it as what? Effective demand. Because I'm having the purchasing power. But in a situation whereby I need this plane, but I don't have money. I need this plane, but I don't have money to buy it. What are we going to call that? I want to demand for it, but I'm not having the purchasing power. That is what we refer to as ineffective demand. It's a situation whereby you are willing to buy a goods and services, but without the purchasing power for it. That means you don't have the money you will use to buy it. Then we now say that it is what? Ineffective demand. And that is what leads us to what's known as effective demand and ineffective demand. As you can see, we now say that we have effective demand and what? Ineffective demand. Effective demand, that is when you have the purchasing power to pay for that goods and services you are demanding for. But when you don't have the purchasing power, you don't have the money to pay for it, then we say that it is what? Ineffective demand. That shows that you don't have the purchasing power, but you wish to have it. And that is what you also know as what? Want. That is why they refer ineffective demand as what? Want. Want is many what? Desire. Is your many desire for goods and services without you having the purchasing power. Now, we move to what is known as loss of demand. What are the loss of demand? There are two basic words, loss of demand. There's what we call the normal law of demand, and there's what we call the abnormal law of what? Demand. What do we mean by normal laws of demand? What do we mean by abnormal law of demand? In the normal law of demand, what do we mean by the normal law of demand? What is the normal law of demand? The normal law of demand, this is the law which says that the higher the price, the lower the quantity to be demanded. The higher the price, the lower the quantity to be what? Demanded. While abnormal law of demand says that the higher the price, the higher the quantity to be demanded. For instance, this is what? This is a noodle. If the price of noodles per one is 15 naira and you have 100 naira with you, you'll be able to purchase what? Two noodles. You'll be able to purchase what? Two noodles. But if the price of the noodles increase to 100 naira per one and you have 100 naira with you as your purchasing power, how many will you be able to purchase? Wow. Only one. So that is what you mean by that. The higher the price, the lower the quantity to be demanded. Because of the increase in price, your quantity has reduced to what? One. When the lower the price, the higher the quantity to be demanded. When the price is low, for instance, per one is 50 naira, you have 100 naira with two. You can buy what? Two. When they now reduce the price to 30 naira, that means it's 100 naira, you'll be able to buy what? Three. That is what we refer to as normal law of demand. Now, what do you mean by abnormal laws of demand? Abnormal laws of demand says that the higher the price, the higher the quantity to be demanded. As the price is increasing, the quantity to be demanded is also what? Increasing. For instance, if the price was 5 naira and you demanded for 3, when the price increases to 10 naira, you demanded for 5. This is also known as abnormal demand. Causes of abnormal demand. Among the causes of it are article of conservation, fear of futurizing price, and inferior goods. When goods is inferior, you prefer to go for the one that has quality, which the price is high. No matter how the price of the quality one is increasing, your demand will also be increasing. Now, that's not because to what's known as. We now move now to factors affecting demand. Demand. What are the factors that affect demand? Number one, we say price. Price, secondly, There are various factors that affect the man. What are these factors that affect the man? We say pride. How did pride affect the man? That was what we explained the last time when we are using Indomie. When the price of these modules, is 5 naira per one, you will be able to demand for one. When the price decreases to 10 naira per one, and you are having 5 naira with you, you may not be able to demand for anything. But in a situation whereby the price of this model is set at 50 naira, if the price is 50 naira and you have 100 naira with you, you can easily demand for what? 2 with 100 naira. But when the price increases, what happens? Increase 100 naira, you may be demand for only what? 1. That is what we mean by price. In price of other commodities, what is the price of other commodities? In the price of other commodities, let us look at wow and clean. This is another commodity. Assuming clean is being sold for 120 and wow is being sold for 100 naira. And normally demand for what? Now you now look at and you are having 100 naira, but normally you used to use the one that is sold for 120. Maybe it means that it's sold for 120, but now you're not like, oh, I'm having 100 naira. Since the price of wow is 100 naira, let me go for wow. These are what's called changes in what? Demand. You may decide to go for 100 naira, but why? You are having 200 naira. Because when you are going for wow, you can buy two. But when you want to go for clean, which is 120, you only buy one. Now, it comes to income. What is income? Income is the money you are owed or money that you got at the end of a particular month. All the money that comes in for you is known as your income, maybe your salaries and wages. Now, when you receive your income, if your income is 20,000 naira per month and you used to buy one bag of rice, which is 10,000 naira. Now, if your income increases to 50,000 naira, you may decide to buy what, 2 bags of rice. That is why we say that income also brought about changes in demand. Change in taste. For how to change in taste, what about changes in demand? For instance, I used to take trim. I love taking trim a lot. It's trim I used to say, oh, anytime I need a soft drink, I take trim. Now, I don't say that, oh, I don't like the taste of trim again. It looks as if it doesn't contain much sugar. Let me go for Coca-Cola. As you are going for Coca-Cola, what happens to the demand for trim? The demand for trim falls. Why the demand for Coca-Cola rise? Which shows that due to what? Changes in taste. Now, we talk about changes in fashion. When we talk about changes in fashion, as a result of changes in fashion, for instance, maybe, oh, it says, oh, FUBU is gaining now. Guys are now putting on FUBU jeans, trousers. Another designer now comes out. Then I name it like, okay, let me say St. John. If St. John designer comes in, you may not want to go for FUBU again. And so let me go for St. John. That is as a result of what changes in fashion. Taxation. What is taxation? We say tax can be defined as a compulsory levy that is being imposed by the government on both the citizens and the corporating bodies of the economy. When there is a change in tax, for instance, government may increase your tax. Maybe before you are paying 10% as tax. 10% of your income, you are earning 20,000 naira. And you pay tax of 10%. If you pay tax of 10% from 20,000 naira, how much will remain? You only say 20,000 times 10 divided by 100. If 0 cancels 0, 0 cancels 0, then you have what left? You have 2,000 left. Now you are paying 2,000 as tax. 20,000 minus 2,000, 2,000 minus 20,000 will give you 18,000. When you now have 18,000 naira, then that is your, maybe that is your income, take home income. You want to take to your own. Now, government now says that we want to increase this tax to 40%. If they increase the tax to 40%, that means the amount that will be removed from your salary will increase, and that will affect the quality of goods and services that you are buying. So, in summary of the fact, we come to demand. We say demand can be divided as the amount of goods and services in which the consumer is willing to buy at a particular period of time within a given price. We talk about that demand can be divided into two, known as effective and ineffective demand. Then we talk about loss of demand, where we say that we have the normal loss of demand and the abnormal loss of demand. Then we talk about factors affecting demand, where we mention the price of other commodities and others. In our next class, we will be looking into concept of demand, but under the concept of demand, we will now be talking about the demand function, demand schedule. Demand function, demand schedule, and demand curve. Then we will look into type of demand.